Hey guys, welcome to the bar. For those of you who watch my channel, you know that I love ice and I love perfectly clear ice, and I'm always trying to find new and better ways to get the most clear piece of ice. So this is an ice experiment. I'll show you how I do it from start to finish, and then we will talk about exactly what the outcome was, which method that I'm using is better. Enjoy.
This is a Kush Tender project we'll be doing today. We'll be making clear ice using a different method than normal from the bottom up. So what we got here first is a big starter pack party stacker situation from Coleman's. And this guy right here, this is a fish tank pump. So we have some more prep to do for this.
As with every project, we need to first head to our local houseware store.
Hi, welcome to Taco Bell. How can I help you?
Yeah, can I have a Crunchwrap Supreme?
Thank you.
Now that we got that out of the way,
hopefully everything in one trip. This looks like some sort of roof situation. These are all too big, but they do have this little one. So we're gonna go with the little one.
We are now going to take, you can see I got a different one. This one, the other one didn't fit in my refrigerator or my freezer. So we gotta get a new one. This is shorter, but still taller than my normal ice making machine. And we are going to saw off the bottom part of this so that it exposes the inside with no insulation. We have sawn through, and now we can start to pull the plastic covering. Get your fingers underneath there and pull it off. We want to expose the little white inner piece, because this will be the part that we are freezing, and this will be the part that we are keeping liquid. It's the reverse of a lake. The lake freezing. Next thing we have to do is we have to make a new lid. The lids that come along with these are not, they're hollow. Nothing in them. So we need the actual lid to work. So we got that insulation. I cut it into three parts, just somewhat getting smaller. And these are just slightly larger than this so that I can glue them together, figure out the shape, and go from there. So I have glued this all together. I've taped it all up so that it fits nice and snug. I think we're ready to try clear ice. Let's try it. The next thing we need is this, which is a pump for a aquarium. That's gonna keep that water churning up on top so nothing freezes on top. It's only freezing on the bottom. We're gonna go ahead and stick this in to the ice, so that it is just barely inside of that water. We're gonna go ahead and put our makeshift top onto it, and we are going to plug in our filter, and that filter should keep water moving around. We're gonna let that freeze in a not super cold freezer, something right around freezing, so right around 32 degrees. We're gonna let that go for about 2 days. I'll be checking it throughout this, but we're about to have a cut where I will change my shirt because hopefully I'll change my, this is gonna take 2 days for this. Hopefully I'll change my shirt in the next 2 days. And I will see you guys then. At this point, I wanted to have a control, so I started making ice the way I normally do, which is a top-down method using this Coleman cooler without its lid freezing from the top down. All right, guys, it has been 2 days. That's normally longer than I put the top down one in, but I don't know about this one, so I'd let them both go for 48 hours, see what we got. Well, the top down method has a bunch of bubbles in it, which means that I probably let it go for too long, and the other one has not even really started to freeze. Small circle on the bottom, so we're gonna give this one more day. All right, so to get this ice out, we're just gonna flip this over on top of a baking sheet until it falls out. I certainly let it go for too long, just in the name of science. You can see all the bubbling made it up here. But this is really nice and clear. So our new method, which is taking at least a day more, is gonna have to
really come through for us.
Okay, it's been a few days. This is now ready. There is a large chunk of ice that goes to about here. So let's pull that out and see how actually clear this is versus the other method. So we have it out. We have flipped it over. We're just waiting for it to drop right now. First thing I do notice, there is a slope to it, but the ice is very clear. Okay, so the ice just dropped, and as it fell through, there was an audible gasp from me. It is so clear. There are no bubbles anywhere in. I've been looking, no bubbles at all. It's coming in much larger than it, with the other method. This is actually clear ice. This is Clinebell clear ice. This is what we're looking for. I mean, this is like a diamond. This is like, it looks like resin. It's so interesting. So, okay. So final thoughts. I'm gonna chop these up, but we'll compare them and then we'll do some final thoughts. All right, guys, so I have now done this experiment 3 times, and every single time I do the bottom-down method, this is the piece of ice I get. It is perfectly clear. It is thick. It is bubbleless. It is exquisite. Now, if you're not that into ice, the top-down method is a great way to make nice, clear ice, but if you are an ice geek, and there are some of us, we are not legion, but there's some of us, the bottom down method with a larger cooler and a fish tank pump, this is the way to go. Let me know if you guys have any questions, comments, concerns. Just write them down below. Please like, share, subscribe to me, and hope to see you at one of my live classes. Thank you so much, and happy ice. Happy ice. Happy ice. Not at all. Happy ice. Bye.